हे क्लास, हाय, हेलो, नमस्ते, आदाब, सत श्री अकाल, अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वणक्कम एंड खम्मा गणी टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम टू टुडेस क्लास. एंड एज यू ऑल नो, दिस इज योर सीबीएसई ग्रेड 9 एंड वी आर स्टार्टिंग लाइंस एंड एंगल्स. सो इन दिस सेशन वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द डेफिनेशंस, द बेसिक टर्म्स व्हिच यू शुड बी अवेयर ऑफ, राइट? सो वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग द क्लास. बिफोर आई स्टार्ट द क्लास, वंस अगेन वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू. And please show us your love and support by liking this video, share the video with your friends, and subscribe to the channel if you are new here, because we are conducting classes like this every day. Okay, so as I was saying, that we'll be starting with the basic terms and definitions. So this chapter is all about lines and angles, as the name is suggesting you. And one of the important part is your parallel lines, right? So the first thing, point. What is a point? So a point is that which has no component. It is represented by a dot. So any dot, if I write a dot, this dot will be called a point. Got it? So remember, point does not have a length, breadth, height, nothing. Point is dimensionless. Okay. One dimension means your lines. Two dimension, you know, your surfaces. Three dimensions are your solids, right? You have studied in your grade 8. So point is dimensionless. It doesn't have length, breadth, or height. That is called point. Now, what is a line? A line means, a line is extended on both the sides indefinitely, right? So when we join two distinct points, then we get a line. Koi bhi do points pe will be joining it, will be getting a line. Remember, line does not have any points, any end points. There is no end points. So this arrow means this line can be extended here further, and this arrow means line can be extended. So this line can be extended on both the sides. This line can be extended on both the sides. Then we have line segment. So line segment means part of a line. Okay. So line segment has a definite length. Okay. It has a definite length. We can measure the length of a line segment because it has fixed endpoints. Both the endpoints are fixed, so we can easily measure the distance between them. Got it? And then a ray. So in a ray, there will be, okay. So, just a second. Yeah. So as I was saying, a line segment has no endpoints at all. ठीक है? So remember, a line segment do not have any endpoints. It will be a fixed length. It will be of fixed length, two points and between them, right? So it has two fixed endpoints and its length can be measured. So this is the difference between the line and the line segment. Line segments do not have any endpoint, and length of line cannot be measured because it can be extended indefinitely. Whereas line segment is a fixed segment. As you can see, segment, part of a line, its length is fixed. It has two fixed end points, right? Then comes the part of a ray. Ray mein what does happens is one end point is fixed and one point can be extended indefinitely. So here also, if I can extend this to any point till I want, so here also length, we cannot measure the length of a ray and a line. But the length of a line segment can be measured. Length of a line segment can be measured. After that, so I have told you, point is this, line, both the endpoints are not fixed, line segment, both endpoints are fixed, and ray may, one endpoint is fixed, one endpoint can be extended. So arrow means you can extend it, dot means stop, fixed endpoint. Got it? Then the next part, collinear and non-collinear points. Up collinear, as the name suggests, if there are three points, and all the three points can be joined using a single straight line. So I can say A, B and C. So I can say A, B and C are collinear points. A, B and C are collinear points. But here if you will see D, E and F, so I cannot join all the three points with a single line. All the three points cannot be joined with a single line. So they are called non-collinear points. They are called non-collinear points. So if there are three non-collinear points, they will form a triangle. And if there are collinear points, three collinear points, they will form a straight line. One more thing you can understand, that two points are ऑलवेज कोलिनियर, टू पॉइंट्स आर ऑलवेज कोलिनियर. वाई बेटा? इफ आई हैव टू पॉइंट्स एनी वेयर, वन पॉइंट हियर वन पॉइंट हियर, सो आई कैन ऑलवेज जॉइन देम विद अ लाइन, विद अ सिंगल लाइन. सो टू पॉइंट्स आर ऑलवेज कोलिनियर. इफ थ्री पॉइंट्स यू वॉन्ट टू चेक दैट वेदर दे आर कोलिनियर और नॉट, join them with a straight line. If four points are there, join them with a straight line. So if they can be joined with a single straight line, then they will be collinear, otherwise not. Okay, so that is your collinear and non-collinear points. After that, the angles. So what is an angle? An angle is two rays originating from the same endpoint. So here, suppose if I have one fixed point. From this fixed point, if I originate this one ray and if I originate this another ray, so this will be the angle between them. The angle between them. So to form an angle, we need one fixed point or two rays originating from one fixed point. Two rays originating from one common point, right? So the rays making an angle are called the arms. So these two will be called your arms, and this point, fixed point, is called your vertex. Got it? Now the types of angles. Acute angle. Acute angle means whose measurement is 0 to 90 degree. Between 0 to 90 degree is your acute angle. Right angle is your 90 degree. Obtuse angle is more than 90 degree but less than 180 degree. 180 degree is called your straight angle. Straight angle. Okay? 180 degree is called your straight angle. If it is more than 180 degree but less than 360 degree, then it is called reflex angle. And if it is complete 360 degree, then it is called complete angle. Remember, 360 degree and 0 degree both will look exactly the same. Hai na? 0 degree mein dekho, OB is like this, OA is also like this. And in 360 degree also, both are at the same place. So when in 360 degree, it completes one full circle. So 0 degree and 360 degree are exactly same. Right? So these are your types of angles. Acute, right, obtuse, straight, reflex, and complete angle. After that comes your topic of complementary angles and supplementary angles. What is complementary angles, beta? Complementary angles means two angles whose sum is always 90 degree. Complementary angle means two angles whose sum is always 90 degree. So this is called your complementary angles. As simple as that. Got it? Two angles that make up 90 degree. Supplementary angle means two angles whose sum is always 180 degree. So complementary angle means sum is always 90 degree. Supplementary means sum is always 180 degree. Sum is always 180 degree. Got it? Ab dekhna. Complementary angles mein, chalo, let's move ahead first. Adjacent angles kya hota hai beta? Adjacent angle means two angles have the same vertex and their one of the arm is common, then these are called adjacent angles. Okay, one more point I would like to add here, that non-common arms, or I would like it over here, for the topic of adjacent angles, the definition is correct, but one more extra point I would like to add over here. First, let's understand. Adjacent angles is, two angles have the same vertex. So vertex is same and a common arm. So one common arm. This is one common arm. So one angle over here, one arm over here. So let's say this A and B. So I can say A and B are adjacent angles. ठीक है? अब देखना बेटा, one more extra point which I wanted to add here is a single vertex, one common arm. One more thing is non-common arms. Non-common arms are on the opposite side of common arms. Non-common arms are on the opposite side of common arms. That is, if this was your common arm, this is your common arm. So the non-common arms for both the angles, one is on the upside, one is on the down. ठीक है? This is how you will get A and B are the adjacent angle. Now suppose if I give you this complete angle, ये जो complete angle है, the angle between the non-common arm is, let us say, 60 degree. So I can say angle A plus angle B will be equal to 60 degree. Got it? As simple as that. So that is your adjacent angles. Now linear pair of angles. What is linear pair of angles? Linear pair of angles is, suppose if I have a straight line. Okay. And on this straight line, if you take any one point and through that point, यू मेक एनी वन रे, कोई भी एक रे, एनी रे एट एनी डायरेक्शन. ओके, सो टू एंगल्स हैव द सेम वर्टेक्स एंड वन कॉमन आर्म, बट द आर्म्स व्हिच आर नॉट कॉमन आर मेकिंग अ लाइन. अनदर वे, अ लाइन ऑन दैट अ पॉइंट, एंड फ्रॉम दैट पॉइंट यू कैन जॉइन एनी, यू कैन ओरिजिनेट एनी रे. सो सपोज दिस इज एंगल ए एंड दिस इज एंगल बी. So as adjacent angle sum is equal to the sum of the total angle, so the total angle here, since it is a straight line, is 180 degree. So angle A plus angle B will be equal to 180 degree, right? Angle A plus angle B is 180 degree. Now, the major doubt here is that, sir, what is the difference between linear pair and the supplementary angles? Because in linear pair also, the sum is 180 degree, and in supplementary angles also, the sum is 180 degree, right? The main difference is for linear pair, it is required, this common arm must be there. This common arm also must be there. So linear pair of angles, you can say they are adjacent angles who are supplementary. Adjacent angles which are supplementary because their angles total is 180 degree. So common arm is must for a linear pair. But for supplementary pair, it is not required. You can have 60 degree angle separate here and 120 degree separate here. So ABC, suppose angle ABC is 60 and angle say DEF is, let's say, 120. Okay. So in this case, you can clearly see they are different angles. So they are not linear pair. You cannot call them linear pair, but I can say they are supplementary. Right. So for supplementary angles, the common arm is not needed, but if there is a linear pair, common arm must be there. Got it? Then vertically opposite angles means if two lines are intersecting each other, so you can clearly see total four angles are formed. So in this, the vertically opposite angles are equal to each other. So this angle and this angle is equal to each other. This angle and this angle will be equal to each other. I will give you the proof for this as well. Okay, beta. So we have done complementary angles, supplementary angles, adjacent angles, common arm is required, linear pair of angles, common arm is required, vertically opposite angles, two lines intersecting each other. So this X formation you will see over here. Okay, now intersecting lines and non-intersecting lines. So intersecting lines means they are intersecting somewhere over here. Non-intersecting lines means the lines, no matter how much you will extend them, they will never intersect. So these kind of lines are called parallel lines. The more common name is what? Parallel lines. Okay. Now remember, if there's a parallel lines, the distance between two lines is always equal. You measure the distance between these two lines, it will always be equal. The distance between two parallel lines is always equal. Parallel lines never intersect. Got it? Ab beta dekho, the vertically opposite angles is true only for intersecting lines. Intersecting lines, when the lines will be intersecting, that time you will get the vertically opposite angles. ठीक है? A pair of angles exam dekh lo. If a ray stands on a line, then the sum of the two adjacent angles formed by that ray is 180 degree. This is your linear pair, nothing else but linear pair. If a ray is standing on a line, so these adjacent angles formed will be supplementary to each other. So that is nothing but linear pair. If the sum of two adjacent angles is 180 degree, then the arms which are not common of the angles form a line. Matlab ki suppose if I give you this, ki this is A, B, C and D. So if I give you this is 120 and this is 60. So you can clearly see that angle ABC plus angle CBD is equal to 180 degree. So these two angles are supplementary. They are adjacent as well as supplementary. That means they are forming a linear pair. So I can say ABD is a straight line. Otherwise not. For example, if I give you something like this, don't look at the diagram. Diagrams are given rough. If it is 60 degree and if it is, let's say, 110 degree. So you will see the sum is 110 plus 60 is 170 only. So I can clearly say this is not a straight line, because the angle has to be 180 degree. For a straight line, anywhere you pick the angle must be 180 degree. Got it? चलो अब वर्टिकली अपोजिट एंगल्स का प्रूफ करते हैं. लेट अस प्रूव वर्टिकली अपोजिट एंगल्स. ओके सो लेट्स से बेटा दिस इज एंगल ए, दिस इज एंगल बी, दिस इज एंगल सी, दिस इज एंगल डी. अच्छा लेट्स गिव सम अदर नेम बिकॉज ए बी सी डी इज ऑलरेडी गिवन एट द वर्टाइसेस ओवर हियर. सो लेट्स से दैट आई हैव द एंगल्स एज पी क्यू आर एस. ठीक है, वी नीड टू प्रूव, टू प्रूव what we need to prove that angle P is equal to angle R and angle Q is equal to angle S, right? A bit of one important thing which I would like to tell you all of you over here, that is whenever we are talking about geometry, in geometry it is very important that you write the reason for each and every statement. First reason I can say ki sir ji, I know AB and CD are two lines, correct? So I can say this P and this Q, they are forming a linear pair. Can you see this linear pair? Dekho, CD is a straight line, OA is a ray coming out of it. CD is a straight line, OA is a ray coming out of it. So P and Q, they will be forming a linear pair. So I can say, sir, angle P plus angle Q is equal to 180 degree. The reason here is linear pair of angles. The reason here is linear pair of angles. If the reason here is linear pair of angles, so I got to know ki sir, they are 180 degree. Let's go for the next part. What is the next part? In the next one, I will say ki, okay sir, now look at this part. Ab AB is also a straight line. AB is also a straight line and this OD is a ray coming out of it. So Q and R are also forming a linear pair. So I can say sir, angle Q plus angle R is also 180 degree because they are also forming a linear pair. Now, focus. But let's say this is your equation 1 and equation 2. So, you know both the equation 1 and equation 2 both are equal to 180 degree. So, I can say that equation 1 and equation 2 can be equated. If RHS is 180 degree for both the equations, LHS also has to be same. So I can say angle P plus angle Q is equal to angle Q plus angle R. Angle Q, if I shift it there, angle Q minus angle Q is 0. So we have got angle P is equal to angle R. Okay. And similarly, I can also prove that angle Q is equal to angle S. Right. This proof is important. Remember this proof. Proof is very easy. P plus Q is a linear pair. Q plus R is also a linear pair. Since sum is 180 degree for both, I can say P plus Q, Q plus R are equal. Q to Q got cancelled, P is equal to R. Similarly, Q is equal to S also can be proved. How? P plus S, you can say, is 180 degree. Q plus P is also 180 degree. P will get cancelled, Q is equal to S. Okay? So for Q is equal to S, two equations you will form. P plus S is equal to 180 degree linear pair. And Q plus P is also 180 degree linear pair. Bas. Solve both. You will get your answer. Solve both. You will get your answer. P to P will get cancelled. Angle Q is equal to angle S. So that is your vertically opposite angle theorem. Now we'll move ahead and solve some questions. So the question says, write the complement of each of the following angles. Complement means that complementary angle for it. So I know for 20 degree what I'll write. So 20 plus that I don't know X. But I know sum will be 90 degree because they are complementary to each other. So X is 70 degree. Right. Similarly for this, 35 plus Y is equal to 90 degree. So Y is equal to 90 minus 35. That is 55 degree. 70 degree and 55 degree is your answer. Similarly, if they ask you to write supplement, so I can say, sir, 54 degree plus X is equal to 180 degree. So X will be equal to 180 minus 54, which is 126 degree, which is equal to what? 126 degree. And here by 132 plus Y should be equal to 180 degree because we are talking about supplement of the angle. So Y is equal to 180 minus 132, which is 48 degree. Got it? So supplementary and complementary can be found out like this. Now let's look at this question. If an angle is 30 degree more than half of its complement, find the measure of the angle. What will be the measure of angle? So what they are saying, एंगल इज 30 डिग्री मोर देन हाफ ऑफ इट्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट. सो वी डोंट नो वॉट इज द कॉम्प्लीमेंट ऑफ दैट एंगल. ठीक है, सो लेट अस से वी डोंट नो वॉट इज द कॉम्प्लीमेंट ऑफ दैट एंगल. लेट अस से कॉम्प्लीमेंट ऑफ द एंगल इज एक्स. सो द एंगल विच वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट, सो द एंगल इज क्या है, एंगल 30 मोर, 30 डिग्री मोर दैट मीन्स प्लस पर 30 मोर देन वन हाफ ऑफ कॉम्प्लीमेंट दैट मीन्स एक्स बाई टू. वन हाफ मीन्स वॉट, हाफ. सो द कॉम्प्लीमेंट ऑफ दैट एंगल इज एक्स, देन आर एंगल विच वी वीन टू वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आउट इज एक्स बाई टू प्लस 30. सो माई एम इज टू गेट वॉट इज माई एंगल. माई एम इज टू गेट वॉट इज द एंगल, दैट मीन्स आई नीड टू फाइंड आउट दिस वैल्यू. सो फर्स्ट वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट एक्स फॉर दैट. आई नो सिंस दे आर कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री टू ईच अदर, एक्स प्लस एक्स बाई टू प्लस 30 will be equal to 90 degree because they are complementary to each other. So x plus x by 2 take LCM is 3x by 2 plus 30 is equal to 90. So you have got 3x by 2 is equal to 60. So x is equal to 60 into 2 by 3. So it will be equal to 20 into 2 is what? 40 degree. So x is 40 degree and my angle will be 40 by 2 plus 30. Which is 20 plus 30, which is 50 degree. So what is our angle? The angle which we need to find out is 50 degree. Ab dekho, many students will get confused here. Why the confusion? Because they will think, sir, x is 40 na, so answer should be 40. But understand, they are saying our angle is 30 more than half of the complement. So our angle is x by 2 plus 30. X is the complement. Got it? So my angle here will be 50 degree. My angle will be here what? Angle will be 50 degree. Got it? So this they have solved by another way. They have told ki let's say our angle is x. So the complement will be 90 minus x. Now they have told ki also given that the complement is what? Our angle is 30 plus half of its complement. So our angle x is 30 plus half of complement we have taken is 90 minus x. So by this also x is equal to 50 degree you are getting. Got it? Anyway, you like, you can solve this question. Now, before I move ahead, I would like to tell you all about this thing that Vedantu has brought this part. Whatever problem you are facing till now, wherever you are studying, one or the other problem if you are facing that is related to the doubts, notes, test, assignments, competitive examination preparation, you don't know from where to do, choice of schedule and the choice of language, all have been taken care of by Vedantu, because now each and every doubt of yours will be solved by a dedicated teacher. Notes will be provided to you free of notes will be provided to you after each and every class, assignments after each and every class, regular interval exam based test series, competitive examinations like NTSC, KVPY, Olympiad, all will be available at one place. Schedule, you can say if you miss your class because of some reason, always you can watch the recording of that class whenever you want, wherever you want in your phone. Okay, and then choice of language, that is Hindi or English. Other than that, you are getting unlimited live classes. You can attend as many live classes as you want. All micro and crash courses will be available to you free of cost. Performance reports will be shared with you and personalized attention to you for checking that where you are how you are making the progress, where you need to focus more and all that. So for that, you need to go to this link vdnt.in/ytpro and the coupon code will be GPEPRO. So at the end, I will show you the fee structure and you can calculate if you are attending, suppose say 8 classes per day at Vedantu's platform, and trust me, the price will be 10 rupees or less than 10 rupees per class. So the prices are that nominal. All of you are more than welcome to join me. And in this course, all the 6 subjects, physics, chemistry, biology, maths, SST, and English will be covered. Okay, now let's move ahead. The next question we have is this. In the below figure, OA and OB are opposite rays. So kya hai? OA and OB are opposite rays. And you can see by looking at the diagram, it is forming a linear pair, है ना? O and OB are opposite rays का meaning क्या हो गया? They are in the opposite direction, so they are a straight line, 180 degree. If two rays are in the opposite direction to each other, that means the angle between them is 180 degree. Okay? So first one they are saying इफ एक्स इज 25 फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ वाई। तो आई नो बेटा कि द फर्स्ट एंगल 2y प्लस 5 प्लस 3x इज इक्वल टू व्हाट 180 डिग्री। सो आई कैन से 2y प्लस 5 x इज व्हाट 25। सो 3 इनटू 25 इज व्हाट 75 इज 180। 75 प्लस 5 इज 80। सो 2y प्लस 80 इज 180। सो यू आर गेटिंग 2y इज इक्वल टू 180 माइनस 80 इज 100 एंड y इज इक्वल टू 50 ओनली, राइट। So y is equal to what? 50 degree. As simple as that. Because the reason, if you want to write here, the reason is linear pair. They are forming a linear pair. Similarly, second one, y is 35 now. So I can say so 2y plus 5 plus 3x again will be equal to 180 degree. The reason is same, linear pair. So y is 35. So 2 into 35 is 70 plus 5. Plus 3x is 180 degree. So 75 plus 3x is 180. Shift 75 over there. So 3x is 180 minus 75 is 105. So x is equal to 105 by 3. So x will be equal to what? X will be equal to 35. Got it? X is equal to 35. That is your answer. Linear pair, you have to get it. So first one, y is equal to 50. Second one, x is equal to 35. Okay, let's look at the next question. This is a good question. They are saying in the given figure, find x if BO, further find angle BOC, COD and AOD. One more thing which should be written here, that AB is a straight line. Okay, it will be given in the question. Here it is missing, so I'm writing it. AB is a straight line. So, I know that since AB is a straight line, I know angle AOB, complete angle, should be 180 degree, because since it is a straight line, AB is a straight line, right? So AOB is made from three parts. One is angle AOD plus angle DOC plus angle COB is equal to 180 degree. AOB is made from three parts. Now this plus this plus this, three parts are there. So AOD is equal to x plus 10 plus DOC is equal to x plus COB is x plus 20 is equal to 180 degree. So x plus x plus x is 3x, 10 plus 20 is 30 is equal to 180. So you are getting 3x is equal to 180 minus 30 is 150. So x is equal to 150 by 3, which is 50 degree. ठीक है, x 50 मिला है. So we have found x. Further find BOC, COD and AOD. So I can say beta angle BOC will be x plus 10, which means 50 plus 10, which is 60 degree. Second part, angle COD or DOC is x only, that is 50 degree. And third, angle COB is x plus 20, that is 50 plus 20, which is 70 degree. Right, so you can see 60 plus 50 plus 70 is equal to 180 degree. My answer is done. Okay, so x is 50 and the angles are 60, 50 and 70. Just replace the values of x. Next question, dekho beta, this is an important question. I want your full attention over here. The question says in figure, angle AOC and BOC form a linear pair. If they are forming a linear pair, I can say it's a very well, sir, angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degree because it is linear pair. Also, one more thing is given, that is A minus 2B. Angle A minus 2 times of angle B is equal to given as 30 degree. They are asking me to find out A and B. A and B find out karne ke liye beta, they are telling me. Theek hai? अब देखो, देयर आर टू वेरिएबल्स. सो व्हेन देयर आर टू वेरिएबल्स, इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू गेट द आंसर. तो इसमें क्या करना है बेटा, पुट एंड टेक एनी ऑफ द इक्वेशन. कोई भी एक इक्वेशन ले लो. सपोज यू टेक द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन. सो फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन यू हैव एंगल ए प्लस एंगल बी इज 180 डिग्री. तो आई कैन ऑल्सो से कि सर एंगल ए विल बी इक्वल टू 180 माइनस एंगल बी, right? So this angle B I have as angle B only. Angle A I have told you as 180 minus angle B, because they are supplementary, right? So now I know ki sir B is B only. A can be written as 180 minus angle B. So let us replace that value in this second equation. So this A, which I have got as 180 minus angle B, this value I will replace in this second equation. Ye second equation mein. Do not replace it again in the first equation, to same answer you'll get. So angle A, I will write it as 180 minus angle B. Angle A, I have replaced as 180 minus angle B. And then what you have, minus of 2 times of angle B is equal to 30 degree. So 180 minus minus 2, minus 1 minus 2 is minus 3. So minus 3 times of angle B is equal to 30. Shift 3B over here, 30 over here. So 180 minus 30 is equal to 3 times of angle B. So 150 is equal to 3 times of angle B. So I can say angle B is equal to 150 upon 3, which is equal to 50 degree. Theek hai beta? So we have got angle B is 50 degree. Ab angle A, how would I find out? Very easy, yaar. Angle A, I know, is 180 minus B. 180 minus angle B. So it will be 180 minus angle B is what? 50. That is equal to 130 degree. So A is equal to 130. B is equal to 50. You can clearly see 130 minus 2 times of 50 is 30. It is satisfying the equation. Got it? So B is equal to 50 and A is equal to 130 degree. Got it? Now, this is your homework question. I want you all to solve this question in your homework and let me know what should be your answer for this question. What should be your answer for this question? You have to find the value of X. Got it? So as I was telling you at the starting about the subscription, Vedantu subscription. So here, if you'll go to this link, you will see this page. Here, select your grade 9, select CBSE 2021, then click here on get subscription. As you will click here, it will take you to this page. Up here, you have an option to choose from 1 month, 3 month, 6 months. It is better to choose more number of months because of two reasons. One is your price per month will reduce a lot. Suppose if for 1 month you are paying, suppose 2000 rupees. So for 6 months, it will not be 2000 into 6. It will be less than that. So price per month will be reduced. Second option is ki in 1 month completing the whole course will be very difficult for you. Trust me on this. 6 months is a good enough time where you can do a quality work. You can work on your basics. You can make your basics strong. Okay. So earlier it will show you this price, but this price you can further reduce by applying the coupon code here. The coupon code is GPE Pro. If you will apply this coupon code, you will get 15% off and this will be your new price. Remember, this coupon code is applicable for 1 month, 3 months or 6 months. You can see for 6 months it is only this price. So if you will divide it will be around 1400 to 1500. So that's really low. All of you are more than welcome to join me. Don't forget, the link is here, also mentioned in the description box as well as in the comment section, and the coupon code is GPE Pro. So this is all from my side. Thank you so much, beta, for attending the session. I'll see you soon in the next class. Till then, bye bye, sayonara, khuda hafiz to all of you. Don't forget to like the video, share the video and subscribe to the channel if you are new here. Theek hai, chalo, bye bye to all of you, bye bye.